Okay, everyone, welcome to another set of FFT Arena matches. And on top is Reno's newest team, and it's a very, very long name, so bear with me. It's called, here we go. Peter Pettigrew's production presents Peter Eponymous and the Pacific Peaceniks Paris on top. And on bottom is CT5 Holy's team, Lightning Stab. Alright, Reno has Divine the Oracle, Sacred the Oracle, Heal Sword the Paladin, and Secretly Evil the Samurai. What we got here is two Oracles, one with Draw and Abandon, Defense up, Move MP up. So this one is decently evasive. This one is another decently evasive Oracle, but this time is a support unit. This one, I think, is just a buffer and a debuffer. This is a Paladin with Attack Up and Marisame, so expect South and Cross out of this unit. And we have a Auto Potion Maintenance Samurai. Now, for CT5 Holy, he has Bolt the Scholar, Bolt 2 the Bard, Bolt 3 the Scholar, and Bolt 4 the Scholar. This is a team that was submitted that hasn't been showcased in quite some time, but you all should know this is a lightning absorbing team. We have two draw bots in the Bard and the Scholar, both having very high MA. And of course, the draw overwhelm combo is a setup I actually made famous about a year or so back. This is pretty much a magic based team using Thunder as its main offense. Alright, so round one between Reno and CT5 Holy. We are going to map 105. Terminate. This should be a very, very exciting match. We have Reno in the black and CT5 Holy in the yellow. See a Masamune from one of the Oracles. This one's looking for a sleep proc. See, Bolt 2 will rush forward. Goes for a very damaging Kotetsu. And Heal Sword will go for a Marisame Slash. Healing all that Kotetsu damage away. Secretly Evil will go for a Marisame. See, Sleep will go off on the bar, which does hit. Shiva hits two people. He's going to trigger Auto Potion on one. Ooh, a kill and another kill after a frog proc. Wow. CT5 Holy is definitely ahead here. A Kiyomori onto CT5 Holy's Bard. But yeah, great strain of offense shown by CT5 Holy thus far. Secretly Evil will rush in. Goes for a double panel Kiyomori. Shiva dropping one of the other Oracles. Oh, redirecting that bio too. Faith up again. No auto potion, so that means CT5 Holy's got this one. No problem. Kiku to wake up the Bard. Interesting tactic right there. Secretly Evil to be looking for more Kiyomori, I guess. Don't know why she just didn't heal herself. Oh well. Well, that was quick. CT5 Holy will be taking round one. We'll see what happens in round two. Here we go for round two. This time we're at map 23, Blue Resonance. This one's a little bit smaller than the first one. But yeah, CT5 Holy pretty much dominated the first round, no problem. We're going to see if Reno can make some sort of a comeback here. And force a tiebreaker. Kotetsu. Interesting that it did not hit the Scholar in that position. I wonder why. Well, we're going to see a Kiyomori. Beezenboat would have been a little bit better. Shiva hitting three panel. She got a potion. Oh, God. Yeah, that's immediately two on four. I don't know if Reno really has a shot against this type of onslaught here. Knowing how much damage pretty much everyone on CT5 Holy Squad can do. These scholars are certainly relentless. Amir Same, surprised that, that samurai decided not to heal her comrades. I guess she's in it to survive herself as long as she can. Unfortunately, I don't think that's going to matter too much. Another bio too. Yeah, why didn't she use Beeson Boat earlier? That would have tremendously helped Reno survive CT5 Holy's offense here. Bounce on Magic Sonic, excuse me, miss everyone. Well, I guess it was what it was. CT5 Holy wins. GG.